exceptional durability and efficiency. What else can be the criteria when we are talking about fuel oil transfer in any industry or in oil refineries? Hello everyone, my name is Aisha Tuba Khan. I am a student of BTech in the Department of Electrical Engineering from Aligarh Muslim University. I am going to demonstrate the project on automated pump control system. This project is developed in Industrial Automation Lab in the Department of Electrical Engineering and it is supported by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India under TechWeb Second National Project Implementation Unit and the World Bank. Technical guidance is provided by Zydamus Technology. Now, let's have a look to the project overview. First, we will describe the real-world problem, then the concept involved behind the automation. Then we will discuss the programming and the visualization of the pump control system. And finally, we will look for the steps that can be further implemented to make the project more advanced. Now, talking about the real-world problem, where the requirement is to maintain the pressure level in the pipeline in any industry or in oil refineries. If this task is done manually, it will be labor-intensive and it will not be possible in unmanned locations along the pipeline and of course, it will be an expensive job. Today's economy has developed an increased appetite for oil and therefore, the pressure and the flow rate in the pipelines must be maintained. In parallel, the power consumption by the pumps must be reduced to minimize carbon dioxide emissions. So, we need to have automated pump control system to overcome all these problems. Moreover, with the help of automated pump control system, emergency situations can be handled more easily and efficiently. Now, coming to the automation concept. This is the three-phase power supply which is energizing the four pump control system. This is the digital pressure sensor installed in the pipeline where the pressure level has to be maintained. This is the start-stop button for pump control system. We are also having Janitzer power quality analyzer in order to prevent the pump control system being damaged from poor power quality such as overvoltage, undervoltage conditions, etc. Next is our central intelligence device, that is the programmable logic controller. All the digital signals are connected to the PLC via hard wiring. For monitoring and control, PLC is connected to the visualization system, which may be either HMI or SCADA system. In our case, it is touch panel. Basically, PLC receives the digital signal from the sensor and it generates an actuating signal for operation of the pump according to the logic. Now, the project engineering is divided into two parts. The first part involves the programming of PLC using Siemens Totally Integrated Automation, in short, TIA software. Second part is about the development of suitable screens for overall visualization of the system using Siemens WinCC Flexible. Here we have to create the text, we have to create the logic and after testing we will download it to the PLC. Similarly for visualization we have to create the connection and text, then after creating the screens we will test it and then we will download it to the HMI. Before we proceed further, I would like to make you familiar with the hardware used. This is our S7300 PLC. First unit is the power supply unit which is having single phase 220 volt AC as input and the output is 24 volt DC. On the second slot is our CPU which is 314 C2 PNDP. This CPU has multiple communication interfaces. As you can see, this is the Ethernet interface and this is the Profibus interface. This is our micro memory card and these are the modules for analog and digital input and output. This is unmanaged switch. These are the buttons for digital inputs and outputs and this one is for analog signal. This is integrated touch panel which in our case is TP177B. This is the Ethernet interface and this is Profibus interface. In our entire project, we have used Profinet so we have only Ethernet connection. Now let's have an insight to the programming part. You can see our CPU from the catalog as 314 C2 PNDP. This is the Profinet interface and you can see the IP address from here. we are having 0, 1 and 2 bytes for input and 0 and 1 byte for output. These are the PLC tags that we have defined for digital input and output. These are the memory markers which corresponds to intermediate memory states. We have also defined some tags so that the input can be directly given through HMI. Now coming to the main programming part. This is the main block. Here we have to control the four pumps which are evenly utilized by switching in and switching out the pumps, taking into account their operating time. The use of pump cascade increases the availability of the system and it simplifies the maintenance network. We have the digital input for pressure sensor which tells us oil pressure as a function of the demand. The programming is done in FBD, that is functional block diagram. Here we have total 9 networks and including 2 function calls for low pressure and high pressure condition. And each of these 2 function calls have 5 networks. Since the limited time do not allow us to explain the whole logic involved behind the programming, so we simply now download it to the PLC and demonstrate the live working. Now, coming to the visualization part, we are having 2 screens, the start screen and the process screen. These are the tags that we have defined for depicting the ongoing process. The acquisition cycle is kept as 1 second. There is a logical connection between the PLC and HMI. The connection interface is the Ethernet cable and these are the IP addresses for PLC and HMI devices. Now let's download it to the HMI to have a standalone operation between the PLC and HMI. So we are now ready to see the live working of the project. This is the start screen and this is the main screen which shows the 4 pump control system. These are the 4 pumps. This is the main startup button. These are the buttons for low pressure and high pressure conditions. We press this button and now our system is ready to operate. Let's first consider the low pressure condition. When we press the button, pumps will start one by one with a duration of 5 seconds. So you can see pump 1 has been started and after a duration of 5 seconds, pump 2 will operate. And similarly, each of these pumps will start after a duration of 5 seconds. Now let's have a look to the condition when there is high pressure in the pipeline. Each of the pump will now stop with a duration of 5 seconds until the normal condition is achieved. And you can observe the pump that was started earlier will be stopped first. So this was the live working of the project. Since improvement is a never-ending exercise, there are few steps that can be further implemented to make the project more advanced. The PLC can be remotely accessed over 3G network or broadband internet. Since we are having internet connection, we will be in sore need of cyber security. It will be more interesting to have the live model of the project here in the Department of Electrical Engineering. We can also deploy Profinet remote input and output instead of local input and output. We can also integrate Genitsa Power Quality Analyzer using Profibus interface to have seamless energy data integration. So this was all about the automated pump control system. At last, all praises are due to Almighty Allah who gave me the potential to work on this project and I would like to extend my gratitude to the Department of Electrical Engineering, Aligarh Muslim University for providing all the required facilities and my heartfelt thanks to ZMS Technology for immense technical support and help. My special thanks are extended to the co-trainers for valuable suggestions and true guidance. I am also thankful to my family and friends for always being there as a great source of support and encouragement. Thank you and don't forget to watch other videos.